Welcome back, YouTube, for the next episode of First Generation Farm. We just arrived to hopefully pick up our planting tractor, as long as it can handle it. Should. We just talked to the gentleman. He told us the tractor that we bought is out in the other barn, but there is a tractor here in this garage right here. And he said I can go ahead and take a look at if I'm interested. Throw him an offer. If not, he understands. So let's see what he's trying to sell us here. All right. If I can get these doors open. Looks like a nice old Alice Chalmers 7080. What appears to be a Cummins swap in it. Not too shabby. That would make a good planting tractor also, I think. I am a fan of Alice's, and this guy, I guess, likes them also. So let's check out the interior. Not too shabby for an interior. You can tell it's been used, but I think it's been kept in pretty good shape. He said I can try her out, so let's start her up. Oh. There we go. Sounds good. It looks good too. Got what looks like turf tires on the front. Don't keep this running too long in here before we start putting a little too much exhaust fumes in here. He said he just got done rebuilding this one. I do not doubt that. That is a nice tractor. You know, I think we're going to have to pass this time. I hate to do it because I'm sure we could find a use for that. But I'm going to be honest, I don't think the trailer and the Dodge can handle two tractors. So we might have to come back for that one at a later date. We're going to cruise over to his pole barn right over here. We're going to pick up a little surprise I have for you guys. As we can weasel it in here. I'm hoping this goes all the way around and I can just park here. Pull down the automatic ramps. And let's go get our semi brand new tractor. I see you guys looking at that Alice Chalmers. That one is also for sale. That is not what we got though. We'll check this out first though. Looks like it's a newer 8070, a four-wheel drive one, or front wheel assist, whatever you want to call them. Looks to be in pretty good shape. I like it. That one's a little pricey for what I think it's worth, so probably won't be picking that up anytime soon, but this 2805 Massey Ferguson. This thing was clean as can be. Very, very low hours on it. Allegedly was bought, never really used, and almost just stored in a barn its entire life. Definitely tell how clean it is. That's probably true. Let's check out the interior. This is what you'd call a clean old tractor, without a doubt. No rips in the seat. The dash is pretty perfect. Let's see if she starts right up for us. First try. We'll let her warm up. Sounds like she's got some power to her. The gentleman said he did rework the engine a little bit, cleaned her up. Should be pushing out a little bit more horsepower and torque, so I think it's going to be plenty for planter, and I think even if we upgrade planters, it might be, still might be able to use this one. We'll see. If it struggles with the newer planter, then we'll probably have to upgrade, but for now, I don't plan on spending, I'm hoping not to spend a whole lot of money on a planter. Just one that'll get the job done. Man, this tractor sounds good. See how she drives. This for sure will do what we need it to do. Now, moment of truth. We're the truck and trailer holder. That Dodge's squatting a little bit. That should be good. Throw some straps on her. Start those grill back up and flip those ramps up. Got a little bit of a squat, but honestly not too bad. I think we'll be able to handle it just fine. That's what I'm hoping. Looks like the dual rears stick out a little bit on the trailer, but I don't think it's going to be anything that the local cops are going to mess with, so we should be good. Old pop machine? That's interesting. Looks like we are clear for takeoff.
Nice trip up. Looks like the masked person has made home. No idea. Right here.
Hold on those wraps.
Oh, yeah, just move a little bit. Okay.
Over here. Don't worry about now.
Over. It's an older planner, but I think I'll get the job done. I'm not worried about it. It was on the cheaper end, so that is a positive at least.
Well, good news. I believe our planter just got delivered. Dropped it off in the yard. It's an older case, I believe 12-row planter. Nothing special with a little couple fertilizer tanks. Again, nothing special, it was cheap, but I think she'll do just fine getting the job done. So I'm gonna go get the Massey, I'm gonna hook her up, probably pull her into the building and give her a once over and see how she is. Make sure there's no parts that need to be replaced, get her ready for planting here, hopefully in a day or two. Next ride up. A real question. Will she fit in the doors? I know I keep thinking that these doors are tiny, which are still pretty good-sized doors, but eventually stuff's just going to get too wide, maybe too tall. This is unfortunate. Check this over, see how Josh is doing in the field. You guys enjoyed this episode. Again, I'm not going to tell you to hit the like button or subscribe or anything like that. If you guys enjoyed the content, hopefully you'll stick around for the next one.